Good day to you. Today the Lord's vision and word came as fostering the strength of love. I saw a mom and carrying a baby at her breast, and the Lord said, this is how you need to foster that strength of love with me, which is going to be your greatest strength. It's the hour for the strength of love. You have had other strengths, preaching, knowledge, but this is the hour for the strength of love. And from Song of Songs 2, my beloved is mine and I am his, and his banner over me is love. So the strength, the victory, banner means the strength, the victory, and how the warfare will be won is through love. Banner over me is love. So it's a banner for the battles of the end time. It's that the Lord's love being poured out into us, poured into us and poured out of us. That's how the bride will be a bride much loved, and bride brilliant in battle, because it is for her, it's for her beloved, that the battle is for her beloved, with her beloved. That's how the bride will be chosen, called, chosen and faithful. That's what we want to be. And it was a very intimate way of the Lord drawing us into his love with much weeping, that if we would be filled with love. At present Sri Lanka is having floods, damaging, devastating floods. But if we would have the love of God flowing through us, it would not be destructive floods of too much rain, but it would be a flood of God's love. This is our prayer for our nation and for ourselves. May you pray like that for your nation and for yourself. And Psalm 37 gives us the scenario, how the world's viciousness goes on. I saw it like a merry-go-round. Actually, I called it a tragic-go-round. And they are taking, when it's turning, about 10% of people get thrown off and nobody is concerned. The center, the controlling, powerful center, is only interested in they having the best. And others get thrown out. But the Lord is making his highway of love, so that those who fall off will cry out, and God's people will stretch out their hand and take them into the Lord's highway, which is moving like a giant little raft, I would say. It doesn't look impressive. It has many feet, many differently abled people, not much brilliant, not that brilliant people are not there, but that's not the qualification. It's a place to strengthen, to encourage the exhausted, strengthen the feeble, as Isaiah 35 verse 3 and 4 say. Today we are looking at Isaiah 37. Do not fret because of evildoers. Be not envious towards wrongdoers. Particularly in this end time, such things will increase. If we fret, we will only lose our energy. What's the option? Trust in the Lord and do good. Dwell in the land and cultivate faithfulness. This is what we are to do at this time. Delight yourself in the Lord, in his love, his loving kindness. Meditate, ruminate, reminisce. Always turn over in your mind the goodness of the Lord, nothing else. But there are many evil things happening, many unfair things, much fake signs, but you have to turn your mind on, delight yourself in the Lord. It's a great challenge to me because of my science and medical background. I want to research and see what a lot of fraud goes on in the name of so-called fake science, pandemic science. But the Lord says, delight yourself in the Lord. He will give you the desires of your heart. So this is where love comes. What desire is about the love, loving relationship with the Lord. So because of the desire of our heart is as he was, to see that the fruit of Jesus' travail on the cross comes to every soul that we can influence, everyone we know. I have made 9 broadcast groups from my phone, which means about how many numbers? It's over nearly 3,000 now, and I'm saying, Lord, every one of them must come to know Christ. Every one of them must come to know Christ. Commit your way to the Lord, trust also. And he will bring your righteousness as the light and your judgment as the noonday. So don't take judgment to your hand. God will bring it forth in his time. So we are to rest in the Lord. We are to cease from anger, forsake wrath. Verse 8 reminds us again, you can see the cycles, what we should do, what we shouldn't do. So what we should do is rest in the Lord. What we shouldn't do is do not fret. Cease from anger, forsake wrath. Do not fret, it leads only to evildoers. And then again we are told, evildoers will be cut off, but those who wait for the Lord, they will inherit the land. So it's, the whole psalm is about wickedness is on one side, but faithfulness is on this side. So our highway is called faithfulness and loving kindness. That other highway leading to Armageddon and destruction and to the self-will of man. We know already the book of Revelation itemizes what will happen. So let's cultivate goodness of the Lord in the land. The steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. He delights in his way. So even if we slip off, we will not be cast off. We will not fall headlong. Psalm 37, 23 and 24, Lord will pick us up. And the meek shall rule the earth, meek shall inherit the land, is the great promise of this psalm. So God bless you, God strengthen you with the promise of this psalm.